Morning, friends.
So just to go through the problem. Compression coil spring made of alloy steel having the following specifications. Mean diameter of coil is 50 millimeters. Eye diameter is 5 millimeters. Number of active coils 20. Right? So this is the data given with respect to the spring. The spring is subjected to an axial load of 500 newtons. Calculate maximum shear stress induced in the spring. And here it is given that neglect the effect of curvature. Right? So this is just a substitution in the shear stress equation. Right? Look at this. Mean coil diameter is capital D. Wire diameter is small d. Number of active coils n, small n equal to 20. And the load W is 500 newtons. So shear stress equation. Shear stress factor into this one. 8WD divided by 5D cube, right? So So first it is made up of wire of diameter. Wire diameter is given.
Mean diameter.
Wire diameter.
5 mm.
Right? Then coil diameter.
50 mm. 50, sir.
Coil diameter is capital D equal to 50 mm. Right? Then load. Load on the spring is given.
500 newtons.
Load on spring. Load on spring W equal to 500 newtons. Okay. Then number of coils. Number of active coils. So what is the notation we have used for to indicate this? Small n.
Small n.
So number of active coils 20, eh?
Yes, sir.
20. So this is the data given to you. Now you are asked to find out Engan Kali
maximum shear stress.
To find out maximum shear stress induced in the spring. Right. So this is a direct substitution of data, right? You know the equation for shear stress. So here it is given that curvature effect is neglected, right? It is given that neglect the curvature effect. Right. So, if we consider the curvature effect into consideration, you need to consider which factor?
Bending moment.
Wall stress factor. Right. So, wall stress factor is K is equal to 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 by C. This is the factor you need to consider if the curvature effect is taken into the consideration. Okay. If the curvature effect is not taken into the consideration, then K is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2C. 1 plus 1 by 2C. That's why this is indicated with K suffix S. K suffix S. Shear stress factor. And this is wall stress factor, right? If the curvature effect is taken into the consideration, you need to use this K. If the curvature effect is neglected, you need to consider this one. Okay, so this is called stress factor, shear stress factor. What is C here? What is C? Spring index, right? First you find out spring index. Spring index C is equal to capital D by small d. Okay, capital D is 50, small d is 5. What is the spring index value?
10.
What is the spring index?
10, sir.
10. Therefore, stress factor. Shear stress factor. KS equal to 1 plus 1 by 2C. Okay. So, 1 plus 1 by 20. 1 by 20 is? How much is 1 by 20? 1 by 2.5. 1 by 20 is?
0.05.
0.05. So that is equal to 1.05. So what is the unit of it? No unit. It is dimensionless. Right? So this is 10 and this is 0.05. Okay. Now shear stress. Shear stress induced. Tau is equal to, what is the formula? As into 8WD divided by 5D cube. So if you have the data books, you can just open your data books. The equations available in our data book. Okay. Then 1.05 into 8 into W is 500 newtons. T is 50 millimeters. Okay. Then I into small d value 5 cube. Right? right? So this D is in terms of millimeters. This small d is also in terms of millimeters. So 1 millimeter cancel with 1 millimeter here. Then you will get millimeter square. Here this is newtons, and this is your dimensionless. Finally, you will get the value in terms of newton per mm square. Okay, tell me the value.
534.76.
How much it is?
534.76.
5 7 6 newton per mm square. Okay, so this is the way you can calculate shear stress induced in the spring. Okay, now here, if the curvature effect is taken into the consideration, instead of Ks, you will get K. You have to calculate K, that is equal to 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 by C, right? So since it is given that the curvature effect is neglected, that's why we have considered Ks instead of K. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
We'll see next problem. Okay, we'll go to the right, look at the next problem. Design a spring for a balance. What is the application of the spring here?
Balance.
What is the application of spring?
Balance.
It is a spring balance, right? So, which is used to measure spring balance application is? What is the application of the spring? Spring balance.
And moderate the speed.
To measure the weight of the members, right? So spring balance is used to measure the weight. So this range of weight is given as 0 to 1000 newtons or a scale of length. What is the length of the scale here? 80 millimeters. The spring is to be enclosed in a casing of 25 millimeters diameter. The approximate number of turns is 30. The modulus of rigidity of spring material given as 85 kilonewton per mm square. Right? Also calculate the maximum shear stress induced in the spring. Okay. Clear? So the application of the spring is, it is a spring for spring balance. Right? It is a helical spring for spring balance. Just to note on the data. Spring balance used to measure a weight of, what is the maximum weight that can be measured? W is equal to 1000 newtons. Right? The range of maximum load or the range of load. Maximum load W is equal to 1000 newtons. Right? Then over a scale of length 80 millimeters, under the application of this 1000 newtons, the spring gets compressed maximum to a value of 80 millimeters. So here 80 millimeters length of the scale, nothing but deflection of the spring. Okay. So the spring is enclosed in a casing of 25 mm diameter. So if you want to enclose a spring, right, that enclosure must have the diameter of 25 mm. So the outside diameter of the spring is nothing but coil diameter. So what is the diameter of the coil here? 25 millimeters. Okay. Then number of active turns, it is given as number of active turns. Then modulus of rigidity is given as G is equal to 85 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per mm square. Right? So you are asked to find out. ఏం కనుక్కో ఉన్నారు మిమ్మల్ని?
Maximum shear stress induced in the spring.
So maximum shear stress. Before that, you need to design the spring. Spring design is nothing but? Spring design is nothing but determination of wire diameter. Determination of wire diameter. Okay. So the session is running out of time. Maybe at any moment of time it may stop. Right? So just
okay, sir.
Right, look at the data. So load on the maximum load on the spring 1000 newtons. So length of the spring balance, that is nothing but deflection of the spring, maximum deflection of the spring. And this is the casing diameter, that is nothing but outside diameter of the coil. This is nothing but outside diameter of the coil. And this is N, number of active turns.
Number of coils.
Right? For example, if we take casing, this is a casing whose outside diameter is given. Right? And your spring will be enclosed in this, like this. Okay. So, but the diameter you are going to use in your shear stress calculation is mean diameter. Right? Mean diameter D is equal to outside diameter minus wire diameter. This is the diameter we are going to use in our calculations. So capital D naught minus small d, but D is, small d is unknown, right? And you are asked to find out shear stress also, right? To find out these two parameters, you need to calculate, right? So wire diameter and shear stress. First, D naught is 25 and small d is unknown. Okay. So, but deflection is given. What is the formula for deflection? Deflection WD is equal to 8 WD cube N divided by GD to the power of 4. This is a deflection equation. Here you know the value of deflection 80, which is equal to 8 into W is 1000 into D is 25 minus D whole cube into N is 30 divided by G is 25 into 10 to the power of 3 into D is unknown, D to the power of 4. So from this, what is unknown here? Only D is unknown. You have to calculate D value. Okay. So once we have D value, shear stress equation, tau is equal to K into, right? K into formula ND. 8 WD by 5 D cube. So, ikkada small d vastundi kabatti capital D vastundi. What is K here? Where K is wall stress factor. K is equal to 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 by C. Right? Where C is equal to capital D by small d. Okay. So, first you calculate this value. Then calculate this value, then third one. First one, second one, third one. Then finally you can find out shear stress value in terms of Newton per mm square. This is the fourth parameter you need to calculate. Got it, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So first you find out small d value. From that,
4.21, sir.
How much it is?
4.21, sir.
4.21. So you take it as 5 millimeters. Okay. Then,
okay.
If it is 5 millimeters, capital D equal to 25 minus 5.
20.
Now, spring index 20 by 5. 4. Now you calculate this K value. 4 into 4. 4 into 4.
16, sir.
So 16 minus 1. 15 divided by 12 plus 0.615 by 4. You will get K value.
Okay, sir.
How much it is?
1.40, sir.
1.40. 1.40. Right. Now you substitute here so that you will get the value 1.40 to 8 to 1000 into D is 20 divided by 5 into 5 cube. And that's the next one.
Five seventy point four one.
Anybody got the same value? Newton per mm square. Okay. So this parameter is regarding the design part where we have calculated the diameter, right? That is nothing but the design of string. So with respect to the string design, this is important parameter. Design is nothing but dimensional proportions. right? And anyway, coil diameter is, this is coil diameter, right? And this is spring index, this is Walls factor, and this TSS factor. Then at the end, we just indicate the summary of all these parameters, right? Everybody, wire diameter, coil diameter, then
TSS.
Okay. You can indicate solid length is equal to n into d. Solid length is equal to n into d. Similarly, LF is equal to LS plus 1.15 into delta. This is LF, right? Okay. So these parameters you can find out, and at the end you have to draw the figure, right? So no need to draw this type of figure. You just indicate the line diagram morning. You have considered the spring like this. Right? The figure KC, you have to mark all the values. What is the outside diameter? Right? What is the wire diameter? What is the coil diameter? Then what will be the pitch of this? You can also calculate pitch if you know the free length and solid length. Okay, so you have the equations to find out pitch of the coils also. Right? Is it clear? All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So you go through some more examples in our textbook so that your the equations are simple. Whatever the equations we have used in our previous designs, same equations we are going to use, right? Anyway, these equations are familiar to you in the MOS lab itself because you have done spring test, right?
Okay, sir.
So only thing is, at the end, you need to indicate the summary in a very clear cut.